Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Announcing the arrival of Professor Dr. Rofina Yasmin Osman, Associate Vice Chancellor of Industry and Community Networks, University of Malaya, and Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani, Dean of Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology, University of Malaya. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Distinguished guests, Professor Dr. Rofina Yasmin Osman, Associate Vice Chancellor of Industry and Community Networks, University of Malaya. Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani, Dean of Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology, University of Malaya. Professor Emeritus Datuk Sri Dr. Mashkuri Yaakob, representative from Academy Science Malaysia. Professor Datuk Dr. Zulkifli Buang, Assistant Vice Chancellor of Technical University of Malaysia Melaka. Deans, Directors and Deputy Deans, Professors and Associate Professors, Management and Lecturers of Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology, University of Malaya. And last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the inaugural lecture by Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani, who will be presenting his lecture entitled Mobile Cloud Computing, Leveraging Capability for Value Creations. Before we begin, I would like to invite Dr. Muhammad Hairul Nizam Muhammad Nasir, Senior Lecturer from Department of Software Engineering, Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology, University of Malaya, to recite the doa.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا شاكرين حمدا حامدين حمدا يوافي نعمه كافي مزيده يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك عظيم سلطانك اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم أحينا بالإيمان وأمتنا بالإيمان وأدخلنا الجنة مع الإيمان اللهم افتح علينا حكمتك وانشر علينا من خزائن رحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعلنا محبوبا في قلوب المؤمنين والمؤمنات وبشرنا بالغناء إلى 120 سنة فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين وبارك لنا اللهم في جمع قصبنا وحل عقد الأسر يا أيها أرمهد اللهم يا غني يا حميد يا مبدئ يا معيد يا فعل لما يريد يا رحيم يا ودود أغنني بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك أمن سواك ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تم على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتغضى به الهوائج وتناله به الرغائب وحسن الحواتم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحات ونفس بأداد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Thank you, Dr. Hairul. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further delay, please welcome Professor Dr. Rofina Yasmin Osman to chair the lecture and introduce Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Yang berbahagia Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani. Yang berbahagia Professor Emeritus Datuk Seri Engineer Dr. Mashkuri Yaakob, Wakil Academy Science Malaysia. Yang berbahagia Prof. Dr. Zulkifli Buang, Assistant Vice Chancellor UTEM, Dekan-dekan tetamu hormat, Prof. Azwan, Prof. Abriza, Profesor-profesor, pensyarah-pensyarah, tetamu-tetamu, pelajar yang dikasihi, keluarga yang dikasihi juga ada berada di sini. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera diucapkan kepada semua hadirin yang dihormati sekalian. Bagi pihak Universiti Malaya, saya mengalu-alukan kehadiran tuan-puan dan amat gembira berada bersama di Fakulti Sains Komputer dan Teknologi Maklumat sempena syarahan perdana Profesor Dr. Abdullah Ghani sebagai Profesor Universiti Malaya dan Fellow Academy Sains Malaysia. Dengan izin, saya akan teruskan dalam bahasa Inggeris. Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, it gives me great pleasure to extend to all of you a very warm welcome. And it is indeed an honor for me on behalf of the University of Malaya to be able to chair this afternoon's inaugural lecture by Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani, Professor University of Malaya and Fellow of the Academy of Sciences Malaysia. To quote an ancient proverb, if you are planning for a year, sow rice. If you are planning for a decade, plant a tree. If you are planning for a lifetime, educate the people. Today, we celebrate an educator, a professor at the University of Malaya. Please allow me to introduce Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani. Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani is a professor at the Department of Computer Systems and Technology, Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology, University of Malaya, Malaysia. He obtained his tertiary academic qualifications of both his bachelor's and master's degree in information management from the University of Hull, United Kingdom, and his PhD in Computer Science from the University of Sheffield, also in the United Kingdom. But not many are aware that his career in academia started much earlier, as prior to his degree studies, he had acquired a teaching certificate from the Kinta Teachers College, Ipoh, and a diploma in Computer Science from Institute Technology Mara. Consequently, he has accumulated extensive teaching experience, having worked in a number of educational institutions, both locally and abroad, from schools and colleges, including the Malay Women's Teaching College in Malacca under the Ministry of Education, through to Rotherham College of Technology and Art in Rotherham, the United Kingdom, and at the University of Sheffield itself, before returning, lucky for us, to join the University of Malaya. His early interest in research kicked off in 1983 when he was first chosen to attend a three-month scientific research course in Wrexham by the Ministry of Education Malaysia. Since then, he has not looked back and has published his research findings in more than 150 academic papers in proceedings and respectable top-ranked journals internationally. The quality of his work is reflected in the number of citations they have received, both in the Web of Science as well as in the Scopus databases. He is a dedicated educator and actively supervises numerous students at all levels of studies, at bachelor's level, master's, and through to PhD. His area of interest in research spans cutting-edge domains in computer science and includes work on self-organized systems, machine learning, reinforcement learning, and wireless-related networks. Currently, Prof. Abdullah's work focuses on mobile cloud computing, having received a high-impact research grant worth $2.5 million. He is also the principal investigator of the research on Al-Quran and Hadith authentication systems. Prof. Abdullah Ghani's work has raised close to $4 million, or more than $1 million in research funding in the last 5 years. Currently, he is the director of the Center for the Mobile Cloud Computing, which carries out programs that focus on the latest high-impact research in this area, as we will hear about today. The center has published more than 60 papers in Tier 1 and Tier 2 ISI Index journals in the last 5 years. Prof. Abdullah Ghani is, as we all know, the Dean of the Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology. Internationally, Prof. Abdullah Ghani serves as a visiting professor at the King Saud University, Saudi Arabia, and as an adjunct professor at COMSAT's Institute of Information Technology, Islamabad, Pakistan. He also serves as a reviewer for several high-impact journals and is the editor-in-chief of the Malaysian Journal of Computer Science, an ISI Index journal. In Malaysia, he is no less recognized and is currently a visiting professor at the University of Malaysia, Sabah, Kota Kinabalu, and also serves as the chairman of the Industry Advisory Panel for the Research Degree Program at UNITEN Malaysia. Prof. Ghani is a senior member of the IEEE, and as a recognition of his academic and professional achievements, he was recently elected as a fellow of the Academy of Sciences Malaysia for engineering and computer science discipline. Today's event, hence, also marks his inaugural speech as a fellow of the Academy. With that brief introduction, I would like to invite Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani to present his lecture entitled Mobile Cloud Computing, Leveraging Capability for Value Creation.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to record my appreciation to MC, Dr. Azmiza. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to Professor Ropina Yasmin for her kindness to chair the session today and to deliver introductory remark about me. I also like to extend my deepest gratitude to all of you who joined me today. I saw many big names here. It's such great privilege to present my lecture with all of you. It's indeed a great honor to be here to deliver an inaugural lecture and to share my work on mobile cloud computing. I promise I won't take long. I try my best to finish it less than 1 hour. That's my promise. Before I start formal lecture, I would like to acknowledge few names that has been my support system. First of all, I would like to, my appreciation goes to my wife, Wanapsia Abdurrahim, whom I love very much. She's a great person who is always support me, understanding me, and make my life beautiful by showering me with love. Wow. Of course, I'm thankful to Allah for teaching me about life through my parents, who had never stopped encouraging me to pursue my studies. My appreciation also goes to my gorgeous children, Ili, Titi, Yin, and Tina, and not forgetting my handsome son-in-law, Izam, and Tina, and also my grandchildren, Michaela and Micah. I would like also to extend my special thanks and appreciation to my sisters who always love me, my sisters. Sorry for taking a bit long to express my gratitude. I have a few more names to mention. Next one is Tan Sri BC and Professor Awang for their continuous support to me, and thank you. In my life, I have many cikgu, many gurus, from primary school to up to university. In working environment, I also got cikgu who had taught me something that I cannot find in books. With great pleasure and honor, I would like to thank Professor Emeritus Datuk Seri Dr. Maskuri Yaakob, Professor Wan Ahmad Tajuddin Wan Abdullah, who are sitting behind the filler out there. And also Professor Dr. Adnan Haji Nawang, who are not able to come today because not really well. I also must mention those who have been working hard to organize these events. So, I have been blessed to have close friends who have been so supportive and kind to me. Of course, they are Professor Datuk Zulkifli Buang and his wife, Datin Naja Farida Putih. I also must mention those who have been working hard to organize this event, especially the team that comprised of my PA, Puan Nordalilia. It's very hard to pronounce because I always call her Yana. And even I cannot pronounce a father name, Kiwam. And Principal Assistant Registrar Puan Nur Mohaini. Also, technical team headed by Dr. Nur Badrul for hard work and excellent preparations. My lecture is about a story. I want to tell you a story of the undertaken research work on mobile computing, leveraging capability for value creations. A story of research work to address the fundamental issues of incompatibility of different computationals and storage power between cloud and smart mobile devices on the technology of the decade for creating commercial, academics, and knowledge values. My lecture will cover several sections: motivation, introductory concept, and the states and weaknesses, improvement work, example or application, value creation, and finally, output of C4MCCR. Let me start by telling how I got the idea to do research in mobile cloud computing. In 2012, I was invited to deliver a keynote speech in Khartoum, Sudan, on e-learning in Islamic countries. It was my first time in Sudan, and also the first time to visit an African country. The visit gave me a chance to view with my eyes the situation in Sudan. Trees planted in front of the house are considered a symbol of status. The more trees are planted, the higher the status symbol of the owner. This is simply due to high cost keeping the trees alive. It needs special attention on watering it every day. Trees in front of the house in Sudan, it's just like having a Mercedes in Malaysia.
Apart from that, Sudan is a vast country and mostly covered with barren deserts, with melting temperature up to 49 degrees Celsius. Almost every day, there's a clear sky with no presence of cloud. The sunlight shines directly without any filter to the ground and makes the soil easily dry up, which restrains the trees to grow. Metaphorically, cloud is a source of rainwater, which is required for a plant to grow. Life exists due to water availability. My visit to Khartoum revealed some facts. Number one, high temperature in Khartoum, which did not allow normal infrastructure of IT to be installed because of the temperature. The mobile devices also had a very low capability. Number three, it was also in expectations in the coming years, the technology of smart mobile devices will grow. Therefore, we have taken an initiative to identify and deal with the challenges of SMD. SMD is small mobile devices, from research perspective. That visit had become a key motivational factor behind the idea of MCC Mobile Cloud Computing. The extreme weather condition in Sudan forces a real challenge for network engineers to provide conventional IT infrastructure. It's not only uneconomical, but also costly to lay down cable in great distance from east to west, which is almost 2,000 kilometers in less density populated area. From Khartoum to Darfur is about 1,600 kilometers away. It triggered me to think how to make such vast area to be provided with IT infrastructure. And it came to my mind that the only working and relatively cheap solution is to provide IT infrastructure by deploying cloud computing. Metaphorically, cloud is a source of rainwater, which is required for plant to grow. Life exists due to water availability. However, cloud computing is not panacea in solving the problem in desert area. It requires mobile devices to access the resources of cloud computing. Unfortunately, mobile devices were still incongruent with the power of cloud. It was the turning point for me to get involved with MCC. It became possible with cloud to deploy services and start using from immediately, which may take long duration in setting up. This is the abstract level of discussion about the benefit of cloud. After that, I set up C4MCCR. I then applied HIR grant and was successfully secured the amount of $2.5 million. And for this, I would like to record my appreciation to Professor Wan Ahmad Tajuddin. At that time, he was the dean of this faculty. He was the one who helped me to fine-tune the application, and I got $2.5 million. With such a big grant, I established Center for Mobile Cloud Computing Research and started to recruit PhD students in RAs. MCC established with a clear vision that is to be a leader in research and training for enriching life and shaping the future through mobile cloud computing. The mission is to drive innovations through applied connectivity. The goal of MCC, as you can see on the screens, is to conserve native resources while performing intensive applications or computations. To augment computing power to enable performing tasks and run computations that could not be otherwise done. In these sections, some concepts related to MCC will be explained. From geographical point of view, cloud contain millions of tiny water droplets, condensing out of the air to form liquid water. From the droplet, it turned to be a drop. It fall down to earth in the form of water. Water is the source of life. The same concept is applied into cloud in computing. The cloud contains all kinds of computational resources, such as data storage, processors, servers, telecommunication devices. If natural clouds are in the sky, computational clouds are located remotely, connected through the means of wireless communications. Cloud computing is a type of internet-based computing that provides shared computing processing resources and data to computers and other devices on demand. Mean that you have to put a request in order to use all the resources. The key use of visualization technology is in server visualization, which use software layer called hypervisor to emulate the underlying hardware. Hope that easy to understand. Historically, it comes from the surface or from the evolution of distributed system and grid computing. It share the same characteristics, resource sharing, distributed task processing, and server cluster. The main difference is on the location of the servers. Cloud are available in great distant locations. Cloud offer at least three types of services. Software as a service, platform as a service, and the third one, infrastructure as a service. So if you look at all the services, one is software, number two is a platform, and number three is the infrastructure. Software as a service allowing end user to run application online without having to install in the local computers the applications. Good example for this is Google Drive. Google Drive allow you to write document using its own word processor and save the document online too. Platform as a service allowing end user to deploy consumer created or acquired application created using programming languages, libraries, services, and tools supported by the providers. In other words, it allows users to do programming to create applications. The third one is infrastructure as a service, allowing end user to use processing power, storage, and network, and other fundamental computing resources remotely. Mobile cloud computing is fundamentally an integration of mobile devices with cloud. Mobile devices are connected to cloud using wireless transmissions. In short, there are three main components in MCC. Number one, cloud. Number two, wireless transmission. And number three, smart mobile devices, or I call it just simply in short form, SMD. Cloud, they are interconnected to make a bigger cloud. This enables it serve a variety of requests or to enhance capability of the cloud. Resources are shared to fulfill the incoming requests. When they are getting bigger, they have more power, they have more resources. It means that they have more power to respond to any requests. Interconnected cloud are called an hybrid cloud, which comprise of public and private cloud. Public cloud are accessible by publics, whereas private cloud is a restricted access cloud. You can see on the slide a picture of monster. Cloud connect each other in order to share their resources and enhance their capability, the word capability. In this way, they become powerful and able to fulfill maximum requests from their users. Connected cloud behave like monster, which are resourceful, powerful, scalable, and highly available. In MCC, there are four types of cloud-based resources, namely distant in mobile cloud, proximate in mobile computing entities, proximate mobile computing entities, and hybrid. Okay. On the other hand, mobile devices are metaphorically mice. Mice, plural for mouse, which suffer scarcity in computing storage and battery life. A mouse is naturally weak to perform heavyweight activities. The concept of mice and monster is well representing the idea of mobile cloud computing. Mobile devices are generally weak to perform heavyweight computational tasks, whereas clouds are monster for having powerful computing resources. This concept of mice and monster bring the idea of mobile cloud computing. Mobile devices are weak and low capable in performing high computational tasks, whereas connected cloud are monster having powerful resources. When the monster, in this case, i.e. powerful cloud, support the mouse, when a monster support a mouse, this low capability device become smart enough to perform whatever action they want. So in other words, the mouse will be helped by the monster to perform their heavyweight task. The task which a mouse was unable to perform because of the weaknesses. With the help of monster, the mouse can perform every imaginable operations. Therefore, this device, mice, are in need of a monster to upload another concept, their task executions and task storage on powerful platform, i.e. the cloud, to perform their user requirements. Okay, now we have to go and try to understand what is the architecture of mobile cloud computing. People ask, what is mobile cloud computing? So there are many ways to define something. There are many ways. One of the methods to define something is by what they call it structuralism. Structuralisms, meaning that you are using the structure to define something. So in this case, I'm using structuralism in defining MCC. And mobile devices comprise of three main components. Number one, you can see that mobile devices is a computing equipment which is expected to be transported during its usage. Number two, cloud. I mentioned just now the cloud. And number three, wireless media. Okay, in the next section, I will try to present the state of MCC by emphasizing on the limitations. This is limitation number one. MCC is not a perfect technology. It has a bunch of challenges to be addressed. In this lecture, I will focus on three main limitations of MCC. Number one, resource scarcity as in small mobile, smart mobile devices. Number two, network scalability. And number three, security. SMDs are actually lightweight devices which are equipped with low capability resources. These resources include storage, RAM, processor, Wi-Fi. All these resources are limited, and thus mobile devices are facing resource scarcity. SMD are designed for mobility purposes, which are featured with lightweight, mobile, and carryable. Thus, the source of power comes from the battery, which is volatile. Oh, you cannot see the background. Okay. Oh, man. Second one is called network scalability. Network scalability refers to how responsive the network to cope up with the changes in traffic volumes in or out of the network. When the traffic increases significantly, it impacts on latency, availability, and throughput. Latency is actually delay in arrival of packet to destinations. Technical term. The transport signal is getting weak during transmission and need re-energizing. Signal also face interference, absorptions, and reflection due to transmission time increasing. Availability refers to signal spectrum from the transmitter. Distance decrease over the signal strength. If the transmission is out of the signal range, the network becomes unavailable. Bandwidth refers to carrier of the data. The size of type of bandwidth determines the speed of transmission. 3G, 4G, LTE are examples of technologies with different bandwidth capacity. The third one, security, refer to cloud security. I'm not talking about network security, I'm talking about cloud security here. Cloud allows data to be stored remotely. However, it raises concern over its security. The concern of data ownership and accessibility. Because when the data has been stored in cloud, the owner is really concerned about the safety of the data being stored remotely. Data loss and leakage can happen in cloud because simply of the platform is shared. Privacy another concern, as the cloud service provider has an access to data being kept by the customer. Despite many preventive measures that has been devised, the concern still remain high. Data integrity and confidentiality are common data access issues on cloud. In the next sections, I will be talking about improvement work that has been done to address those issues. The first one is about offloading. Offloading is a process to migrate computational tasks from SMD, from smartphones, to the cloud. Once the task has been processed at the cloud, then its results will be sent back to the SMD. That's a process called offloading. Cloud is very close to the deployment of hypervisor on the actual servers, meaning that we are creating virtual machine on the actual hardware. This create virtual machine, the virtual entity, depending on the number of actual hardware, will determine the number of virtual machine can be created. For example, one core can create at least 8 virtual machine. In order to get insights of the performance, we conducted an evaluation on the computational performance of MCC offloading. By benchmarking on the systems, application virtualization, and also ARM ISA emulation system, ARM Advanced RSC machines. The evaluation revealed significant amount of overhead occurs, which has been the main cause to restrain seamless operation. We investigated virtual machine deployments and management for application processing and found out that offloading require additional resources on the computational cost. This finding led us to propose energy efficient computational offloading framework, which minimize instances of intensive component migration at the runtime, meaning that we are reducing to and fro from the SMD to the cloud. So another work that we have done is we try to improve resource augmentation using mobile devices. We call it MobiCore. MobiCore ensure mobile devices always have time for its task submitted to the cloudlet. Cloudlet is a local cloud. Cloudlet is a local cloud. MobiCore improve task completion time, service time, number of applications served, and also response times. This slide shows response time as well as improvement in cloudlet CPU. The third one, we try to improve seamless. Seamless meaning that they are doing the job without any delay. So in this case, if you can see that the first work that we have done, we carry out survey to find the state of the art of cloud-based mobile applications framework. And then after that, we investigate the framework suitability for the seamless executions. Then after that, we propose our own framework to improve, to achieve what they call it seamless. Cloudlet is a local cloud platform. I just mentioned just now. Cloudlet is a local cloud platform, meaning that you just simply take one PC, you just install that operating system, then you can turn that local PC become a cloudlet. The cloudlet based framework aim to mitigate the communication overhead compared to cellular network technology that is used to access the remote cloud.
Okay, the next section, I will try to highlight a few relevant applications of MCC. A few only. Recently, we were introduced with Uber. Okay, it's a new mobile application that allows consumer with a smartphone to submit a trip request. Upon receiving the request, the controller will broadcast the request to Uber driver who are nearest to the consumer by providing location information of the request. Upon receiving the trip request, Uber calculate the fare and ETA expected time arrival and broadcast it to the drivers. Grab another example of mobile cloud computing application, which is similar to Uber. The only difference is Uber in terms of how fares are charged. Uber fares are not fixed, depending on the conditions of the depending on additional element of traffic condition. Grab, on the other hand, fixed on fare without any conditions. Uber and Grab use MCC technology of offloading. The calculation of fare and distance are conducted at the cloud, and only the result of the calculation are forwarded to the smartphones. Distance is calculated using GPS, Global Positioning System, and even the movement of drivers are monitored in the real-time mode. This requires heavy computations, which cannot be done by smartphone alone. This is another one. Even though, if you can see that, Microsoft has come up with this kind of new platform, which allows mobile cloud computing to be operated. So allow the execution of many mobile computing applications. It provides a platform and infrastructure for building, deploying, and managing applications and services through global network of Microsoft managed data center. It offers following services: computation, mobile services, storage services, data management, messaging, media services, CDN, developer management, and lastly, machine learning. Now I will go to, I mean, I will, we reach to the last part, maybe. This is not the last part, second last part. I will be talking about the value creations, which is the essence of my lecture today. Value can be meant differently to many people. Value is normally referred to something that is worth of money, but also something that is useful or important in comparison with something else. Improvement on something is also a form of value creations. So I'm trying to give you the definition of value creations, not only money. At the C4MCCR lab, we focus on our effort to create values from research. This is not limited to any specific type of value creation. It can be in the form of publication in top tier of 10% journal ranking, or patent grantings, or commercialized product, or impactful product. Commercialized and impactful. In a larger perspective, value can be created from a shareable environment in which information and resources are the community. Cloud-based platform typically mean that we centralize the information asset onto private and public cloud. Doing so, we provide a common platform for the information. This is another example
where value can be created. Number one, on demand self-service. A consumer can use computing's capabilities, such as server times, network storage, to create whatever they call it value. Second one is what they call it ubiquitous network access. The capability that available over the network and access through standard mechanism that promote use by endogenous thin or thick client platform, such as mobile phone or laptop. The third one is called location-independent resource pooling. The provider's computing resources are pooled to serve all consumers using multi-tenant models, with different physical and virtual resources dynamically assigned and reassigned according to consumer demands. The next one is called rapid elasticity. This is the capability that can rapidly and elastically provision to quickly scale up and rapidly release to the quicker scale downs. Mobile, this is another one, let me share with you. This is more than the technology itself. Okay, we look at from business point of view, how the value can be created. Number one, from what you call it, operational excellence. For a company, they need a standardized services that can reduce the issues and also defect. This increase business continuity and reduce time spent on operational issues. Number two, agility, getting the compute resources you need when you need them, from them tend to a shortened IT project, resulting in the less FTE to deliver the project and quicker and more productive time to market. Number three is called innovations. It has become much easier to start business innovation initiative, often enabled by readily available cloud services. It means that we don't have to create from scratch. You just simply buy the component and use it. The next one is called resource optimizations. A more efficient project and less operational issues allow time can be cut in spending the project. The last one is called capital expertise savings. This one, we are shifting the capital or capex that we have to spend to the cloud provider. So this is another value from academic point of view. Training, number one. Number two, workshop. So meaning that we can have training on online, especially we can have workshop online. This is another one from knowledge perspective. So this lab focuses on high-tier journal productions by providing something, what they call it, contribution to the body of knowledge. C4 MCCR, the center, act as a one-stop access across the academia and industry worldwide, where we exchange information, innovation, and share ideas among our partners all over the world. Moreover, the center will provide seamless experience with global standard on different MCC or CC platform and the current state of the art trends. The center will be dedicated to provide varied services and technical support to diverse ICT industry and academia in the field. The last one, this is the last section. I wouldn't take, I said just now, I promise you I will try to finish before 1 hour, right? So I will try to keep my promise. The next session, I will be sharing about the output of CIPO-MCCR. Being a young establishment, CIPO-MCCR has made remarkable achievement. What are the achievements? Number one, in terms of human resource. You can see that we have produced 6 postdocs. Oh, that one's something. We have RA, local RA. We have 5 local RA. Then we have 12 international RA. So altogether, 17 RA. We have produced 70, more than 70, quality tier 1 papers. 3 patents has been filed with the status of pending. And actually, we are targeting 15. But just because Pro Rafina asked me to slow down, so that's why we are just simply. Okay, and in terms of publication performance, the center has enjoyed some remarkable achievement on the quality as well as setting a record. I'd like to share this. We were the first Malaysian who had published in the highest impact factor journal 9.3 in the world. Okay, this is another example that we want. Just want to show you one person. That's me. You can see that in Web of Science, our citation right now is sum of times is about 730. That one on Web of Science. For Scopus, is 1,222. And even though not something that people don't use it, on Google Scholar, I have about 2,000. I think by today, it's already 3,000. These are the examples. Okay, in the next slide, are the list of selected publication. Same thing. You can see that all of them are tier 1 and tier 1 only. Okay, I would like to share with you, these are these people that I really admire, really, because of their hardworking. Number one, they complete all these people, they are completed their PhD less than 36 months. And two of them, number two and number three, they got distinction in their PhD. And number three, they completed their PhD in 25 months. Number three. Okay, they are really good. They are really, really good, good people. And number one, number two now in Canada. They're getting job in Canada. And number three in Saudi now. Number four is still in China. Number four in Bangladesh. Number five, Mehdi is in Canada. And the last one is now in US working with NIST US. I really want to record my appreciation to all of them. They are really good people. These are the another batch. I call it batch 2. People who already submitted. All of them, they submitted their thesis less than 36 months. Okay? All of them. This is another batch, but still in progress. Still in progress. Even though they are still in progress, some of them already at the final stage, preparing their draft, final stage. Just simply, I think 1 or 2 weeks, maybe they can submit all their thesis. Again, some of them less than 36 months. This is the new one, I call it B3. The new registered students, bunch of students. And lastly, I would like to conclude my lecture today. This lecture is about research in improving the capability of SMD. SMD is smart mobile devices that can generate value. Depending on how you perceive value, but I show you just now, value can be meant differently with too many people. I want to make a statement here. Potential is sky is the limit. Meaning that it depends on your creativity to create value. Finally, I would like to conclude, value creation give advantages to the creator over the competitors. Meaning that if you don't create value, you are just a normal people like them. But if you create values, you are different with them. With that, I would like to thank all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prof. Abdullah. Distinguished guest, now I would like to welcome back Professor Dr. Rofina Yasmin Osman to conclude the lecture which has been delivered by Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani a while ago.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh sekali lagi. Well, before I read my concluding remarks, I have to say, you know, I'm an avid handphone user. As usual, and everything I depend on my handphone. I don't remember anything anymore. Everything is in there. But now I realize my handphone is just a mouse, and there's a monster cloud somewhere controlled by Dr. Prof. Abdullah. That's an interesting idea, and I think congratulate Professor Abdullah Ghani for a very insightful lecture on mobile cloud computing, and I think brings home a lot of messages to us here in the audience today. And when we look at research and the scenario of research today, most academics and researchers don't start with looking at how value can be created from their research. And as Prof. Abdullah rightly said, value can be perceived or can be created in many different ways and can be measured in many different ways, not necessarily, as I would like it, of course, money. Being the PNC for industry linkages. But, you know, we should always consider, as Prof has said, how we can contribute to the economics or sustainability of ourselves and our organization especially. And if I can use the metaphor, his metaphor, in this current cloudy climate, yeah, it is important for all of us to consider how we can create value from whatever we do. I think that's really important. And it's in line with the university strategy, of course, to encourage commercialization. And Prof. Abdullah, in his lecture on MCC, has shown us that there are a lot of opportunities for creating value through the MCC programs. And especially, I'm very impressed by the output of the C4 MCCR, which has really created a lot of waves in the industry. In terms of opportunity and output that University Malaya can provide to the economy as well. So he has described in his talk the kind of potential that can be created by enhancing MCC performance visibility, and of course, at the end of the day, we talk about this all the time, about digital transformation of not just devices, but of our economy and our society as well. And all this can be achieved with effective collaboration, integration, and the support of the university resources and centers like C4 MCCR. So MCC in particular has significantly contributed to ICT industry and business enterprises, and it has become the critical technology for our decade. And I'm sure you have agreed it has revolutionized our daily lives. And we have seen how it can serve as an indispensable technology, as aptly summarized by Prof. Abdullah Ghani in his inaugural speech today. So for that, I thank you, Prof, for a very insightful lecture again. And I'd like to invite the audience again to congratulate and thank Prof. Abdullah Ghani for his excellent inaugural lecture on mobile cloud computing. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Rofida, for chairing the lecture. Now, I would like to invite Professor Emeritus Datuk Sri Dr. Mashkuri Yaakob to present a token of appreciation from the Academy of Science Malaysia to Professor Dr. Abdullah Ghani. Thank you, Professor Mashkuri and Professor Abdullah. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the management, lecturers and staff of the Faculty of Computer Science and Information Technology, University of Malaya, as well as all the guests here for your time. With this, we have reached the end of the lecture. On behalf of the University of Malaya, I would like to apologize if there had been any shortcomings from our side in organizing this lecture. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please rise for Lagu University Malaya. To invite everyone to some refreshments served outside. For VIPs, managements, and family members, please come forward for a photo session with Professor Abdullah. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, thank you and have a pleasant afternoon. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.